Zeal Education Society, redefining excellence.
Welcome back. In the previous lecture, we have solved one numerical on pole placement. In this lecture, we will solve another numerical example. So let us consider the example where what we have to do, we have to determine the state feedback gain matrix to place the closed loop poles of the system having state model. So this is the given state model, A matrix, B matrix, and we have to place the closed loop poles of this system at S equal to minus 1 plus or minus j at S equal to minus 5. And for that we will do it by all three methods. So the first approach is similarity transformation matrix method. So in this approach, the K is given by, now directly I will write it for our case. So in our case, A matrix is of 3 by 3, so it is a third order system. So this K will be alpha 3 minus A 3, alpha 2 minus A 2, alpha 1 minus A 1 into T inverse. So the first step is investigate for complete state controllability. Now in this particular example, as the given system is already in controllable canonical form, in practice there is no need to investigate for complete state controllability, because what we have seen in the previous classes, that if the given system is already in the controllable canonical form, then the system is always state controllable. But still we will follow the procedure and we will find out the controllability matrix M. Now it is a 3 by 3 system, so M will be B, A, B, A square B. And what is A, B here? AB is equal to 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, this is A, into B is 0, 0, 1. And if I do this multiplication, this will be 0, 0 plus 0 plus 0, this will be 0 plus 0 plus 1, this will be 1, and the last one will be minus 3. And then A square B is equal to A into AB. So this will be 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, into AB is 0, 1, minus 3. So this multiplication will be 0 plus 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 0 plus minus 3 is minus 3, and 0 minus 2 plus 9 is 7. And that gives me matrix M equal to B, that is 0, 0, 1, AB, that is 0, 1, minus 3, and A square B, that is 1, minus 3, 7. And if you find out its determinant, it will come minus 1, which is not equal to 0. And hence, system is completely state controllable and pole placement is possible. So next is step 2 is open loop characteristic equation, and that is determinant of SI minus A equal to S minus 1, 0, 0 S minus 1, 1, 2 S plus 3, and this is equal to s into s square plus 3s plus 2. So this will be s cube plus 3s square plus 2s plus, this will be minus minus plus, this will be 1. And this gives me a1 equal to 3, a2 equal to 2, and a1 equal to 1. Now, when the system is already in controllable canonical form, this a1, a2, a3 can be directly obtained from the model. This is minus a3, so a3 is 1. This is minus a2, so a2 is 2. This is minus a1, so a1 is 3. It was possible directly as well. So whenever the system model is in controllable canonical form, the design becomes very simple. No need to perform so many calculations. Many things can be done directly, but still we are following the procedure. Step 3 is closed loop characteristic equation, and the given poles are at s plus 1 minus j into s plus 1 plus j into s plus 5 equal to 0. So if I expand this, this will be s square plus 2s plus 1 plus 1. So s square plus 2s plus 2 into s plus 5, that is equal to, if I do the expansion, it will be s cube plus 5s square plus 2s square, that is 7s square plus 10s plus 2s, that is 12s plus 10. And from this what I get is, so alpha 1 is equal to 7, alpha 2 is equal to 12, alpha 3 is equal to 10. Then step number 4, determine T, transformation matrix T. Now here, in this case, as given model is in controllable canonical form, we get T equal to T inverse equal to identity matrix. And then the problem becomes very simple. Step 5 is determine K. And what is the formula for K? K is equal to alpha 3 minus A3, alpha 2 minus A2, alpha 1 minus A1 into identity matrix. So no need to write. This is the final solution. And here it is equal to, what is alpha 3? Alpha 3 is 10. A3, where is A3? A3 is 1. So 10 minus 1 is 9. Alpha 2, alpha 2 is 12. A2 is 2. So 12 minus 2 is 10. And alpha 1 is 7. A1 is 3. 7 minus 3 is 4. Finish. So many computations are eliminated because the given model is already in controllable canonical form. So this is the utility of controllable canonical form. It reduces the computations by a great extent. Now what we will do? We will solve the same problem by Ackermann's formula, and we shall get the same answer, that is 9, 10, 4. So start with Ackermann's formula. And here the k is given as, in this case, I will write directly for this case, 0, 0, 1, all zeros last one, then m inverse, that is inverse of b, a, b, a square b into phi a. So what I will do here, the step 1 is investigate for complete state controllability. So I will not repeat it now, but what I will do, just I will do here B is equal to, sorry, M is equal to B, AB, A square B, and I will directly write its value which was computed earlier. B was 0, 0, 1, AB is 0, 1, minus 3, and A square B is 1, minus 3, 7. Correct? So determinant of M is equal to minus 1, which is not equal to 0, and hence system is completely state controllable. Purposely I have determined M because here it is required, otherwise I would have written directly that as the given system is in controllable canonical form, system is already completely state controllable, no need to find M. But in this method, that is in Ackermann's formula method, we have to find out M inverse, and that is why I determined M. So step 2, closed loop characteristic equation, and for the poles, given poles, it is S plus 1 plus J into S plus 1 minus J into S plus 5, and we have already determined it as S cube plus 7S square plus 12S plus 10. And that means in step 3, now I can compute phi A, determine phi A, and here phi A will be equal to, just replace S with A, so it will be A cube plus 7A square plus 12A plus 10I. And already we have A, so what I will do, I will not do the calculation, you can do it on the calculator. What I will do, just I will put it here, it is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, cube plus 7 into 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, square plus 12 into 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, plus 10i, that is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And I have computed these values as A cube is, I have the values, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 3, 5, 7, minus 7, minus 11, minus 16. This is A cube. How to calculate this? Using calculator. Just enter the matrix A and find its cube. You will get this. Then 7 into A square, I also, A square also I have. It's 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 3, 5, 7. And plus, what to do? Multiply every element with 12. So 0, 12, 0, 0, 0, 12, minus 12, minus 24, minus 36, plus 10, 0, 0, 0, 10, 0, 0, 0, 10. And now do the addition, even multiply every element by 7, and finally you will get this as 9, 10, 4, minus 4, 1, minus 2, 2, 0, 7. I have already done this calculation at back end, and I am directly writing it, but you can do it very easily using the calculator. So phi A is obtained. Next is, in step 4, determine M inverse. So M inverse is equal to inverse of 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, minus 3, 1, minus 3, 7. It's inverse. You can calculate it by using calculator. It is given by 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. This is M inverse. You can calculate this using calculator. Enter this matrix, take its inverse. You will get this. And then in step 5, determine K. So your K will be all zeros last one into M inverse, that is 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, multiplied with phi A, that is 9, 10, 4, minus 4, 1, minus 2, 2, 0, 7. And it is equal to, if I perform this calculation, 0 plus 0 plus 1, this is 1, 0 plus 0 plus 0, this is 0, 0 plus 0 plus 0, this is 0, multiplied with 9, 10, 4, minus 4, 2, this is 1, 0, minus 2, 7. And if I perform this calculation, it is 9 plus 0 plus 0 is 9, 10 plus 0 plus 0 is 10, and 4 plus 0 plus 0 is 4. So same answer. But what I suggest, if the given system is already in controllable canonical form, then the efforts required to compute K are very less by the method number 1 as compared to this method number 2 and method number 3. Now let us see the method number 3, that is direct computation. Or direct substitution also you can say. In this method again, what is the step 1? Step 1 is investigate for complete state controllability, which already we have done. Just let us rewrite the things. M is equal to B AB A square B, which is equal to, if you are solving only using this method, then you have to compute this. So it's 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, minus 3, 1, minus 3, 7. And hence, its determinant is equal to minus 1, which is not equal to 0. So system is completely state controllable. Then step 2, closed loop characteristic equation, and already we have obtained this in the earlier case. And it is equal to s cube plus 7s square plus 12s plus 10. So this is done. Half of the part is done. Now in step 3, determine another closed loop characteristic equation, that is determinant of si minus a plus bk. So first we will calculate SI minus A plus BK matrix, and that is equal to S 0 0 0 S 0 0 0 S minus 0 1 0 0 0 1 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3, this is SI minus A plus B is 0, 0, 1 and K is K1, K2, K3. So this is equal to S minus 1, 0, 0, S minus 1, 1, 2, S plus 3 plus this will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 multiplying every element is K1, K2, K3 and that is equal to S minus 1, 0, 0, S minus 1, K1 plus 1, K2 plus 2 and S plus K3 plus 3. And now we have to find out the determinant. So it is becoming complex and complex as the order increases. So this determinant will be S into bracket, S into this. So this will be S square plus K3S plus 3S plus K2 plus 2. So this determinant, S into this minor, now plus 1 into this will be 0 and this will be K1 plus 1. So this is equal to S cube plus K3 plus 3 S square. I have taken S common and then K2 plus 2 S plus K1 plus 1. And now by comparing the coefficients of powers of S, step 4, what we get? This S cube matches, no issue. K3 plus 3 is equal to, this is coefficient of S square, so here coefficient of S square is 7, so K3 plus 3 is 7, so K3 is 4. Then this K2 plus 2, K2 plus 2 is equal to 12, so K2 is equal to 10 and finally K1 plus 1 is equal to 10, so K1 is equal to 9, so K is equal to, K1 is 9, K2 is 10, K3 is 4. Now here we got the numbers easy for comparison because of controllable canonical form. But if the given 3 by 3 system is not in controllable canonical form, then this determinant becomes very complex. And you will get the three simultaneous equations which will be dependent on each other. Here we got three independent equations. But in practice you will get three dependent equations and that those three equations we have to solve to get K1, K2, K3. So I recommend that if the specific method is not mentioned and if the given system is already in controllable canonical form, then always go by the similarity transformation matrix method. It is the easiest one as compared to the other. So in the last 3 to 4 lectures we have seen the concept of pole placement and pole placement design by the three different approaches. Also we have solved two numerical examples. In the next lecture, we will move towards the concept of state observer and the design of full order state observer. Let us meet again. Thank you.